Good evening, distinguished guests, ladies, gentlemen, and dear friends. I'm Nabhan Najib of Class 11A from Indian School Muscat, your host, and it's my privilege and pleasure to welcome you all this beautiful evening. Today, we are here for Avenue 2020, a mission to enkindle the minds of students in diversified fields and motivate them to choose the course of their interest and caliber. Today, we are privileged to have with us an eminent personality from Curtin University who will discuss the courses available with them. Over to you, sir, for your presentation.
Hello, everyone. My name is Abdullah Al-Kindi. I am from Curtin University. I work as a private recruitment service provider based here in the Middle East in Oman. I am a Curtin University alumni myself. I studied chemical engineering and Curtin University. I've spent around 6.5 years in Australia, and believe it or not, I actually got all my papers and documents processed by StudyCo back in 2010, 10 years ago. Maybe some of you guys didn't even reached to elementary school by then. So for now, we will do a small presentation just to kind of introduce Curtin University, Perth as a study destination, and it will be around 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and we will leave the floor for questions, and we will try to make it as informal as possible. Before we start, I'll put it in my everyone here in the meeting, my email and my phone number. If you have any questions, I'll be more than happy to answer it later. And like I said, I live here in Oman. And if you guys want to meet at the study board office, anywhere else, I'll be more than happy to do so. I've been doing this for 2 years now, and I can give you my experience as a student when I was there in Curtin. I normally go there every year to meet the students, I look after the Middle Eastern students in general, and be more than happy to meet you guys and talk about my experience there and talk about Curtin University in general. What do they have to offer, rankings and so forth. So let me share my screen to the presentation. One second. Okay, so Curtin University, Perth, Western Australia. Before we start, we're just letting you know, guys, that Curtin University is a global university. It has many campuses around the world, as you can see in Western Australia, Dubai, Malaysia, Mauritius, and Singapore. My name is Abdullah Al-Kindi. I'm a recruitment service provider in Curtin University, Western Australia. I'm based here in Muscat in the Middle East. I look after the Middle Eastern students and represent the university here in the Middle East. Welcome all of you guys, and I'm very happy to see you here. And you guys, if you have any questions, please drop it in the messages, the chat box there. And after I finish the presentation, you can all open our video if you guys would like, and we can have a normal one-to-one conversation. This is a presentation overview. We'll overview Western Australia as a study destination. Introduction to Curtin University, the COVID situation right now, and the student experience at Curtin University. Please, if you do have any questions, please type in the chat function, and I'll answer as I go along. Okay, just make sure that everything is okay. Sorry. This is Perth, Western Australia. Perth is located in the most west region of Australia. It's the capital city of the governorate or the state of Western Australia. It's a relatively a small city, but this is a very vibrant city, many nationalities in the university and in the city in itself. Relatively also a new city compared to Melbourne and Sydney and Brisbane as well. Like I said, it's located in Perth, in the west of Australia. It has a direct flight from Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Singapore. So you can catch a plane from Muscat to Dubai, Dubai straight to West Australia, Perth. And that will take you 10 hours, 10 to 11 hours. This is one of the most kind of our selling point to Western Australia. You know, rather than spending 16 hours to Melbourne or Brisbane on the other side of the world, Perth is considered the closest city. Things you can do in Perth, Western Australia, you can have national parks all around the university and the city itself. You have a Perth Zoo. We have Whiteman Park, which is actually a lovely place where they showcase all of the Australian native animals. We have Elizabeth Quay, which is a very nice place to hang out, lots of performances, music, and so forth. Swan Valley is actually one of my favorite places in Perth, Western Australia. It's kind of a around 20 minutes drive from the city. And there you can find many, like a chocolate factory. You can buy Australian honey for those who would like to buy some wines, some non-alcoholic wines, lots of good sceneries, very good food, and so on. Perth beaches, of course, we can say that we are kind of a beach that's overseeing the Indian Ocean. And you can see in the pictures, very nice place. And if you talk about the weather, Perth is a really nice place. Lots of sunshine all over the all year round. One might think that if he leaves Oman, for those of you who live in Oman with the extreme heat, when you go to Australia, it's relatively hot, I would say, in the summer. But during other times, starting, let's say, February, it's the weather just keeps becoming cool and cool. We don't have that rain every day kind of weather in the winter, but it tends to be quite nice during the whole year. Perth is considered, for the past 13 years, Perth was ranked in the best 10 cities to live in. It's also very close to Far East countries like Singapore, Hong Kong. They share the same time zone. And it's a 3-hour flight to Bali, 5 hours flight to Singapore, around 7 hours, I think, to... I'm not sure if there's a direct flight to India, but it's not very far. It's also rated one of the safest cities in the world. It's one of the healthiest and sunniest cities in the world. In 2018, WA state government introduced additional graduate skilled migration lists with high achieving international graduates, a pathway to a skilled migration. And it's also considered a regional state, a regional city. So if you actually finish any course that is 2 years or more, you'll be able to get a 3-year post-study works right in Australia, in Perth. Perth is also considered the cheapest major city in Australia, having Sydney, which is considered the 10th most expensive city in the world, Melbourne, the 14th, Adelaide, South Australia, 30th, Brisbane is also considered a bit cheap, but Perth is considered the cheapest major city in Australia, and I actually can vouch for that. In my time in Australia, I arrived in Australia in 2010. It was relatively okay by then, and then the prices kind of soared, became more expensive, and as the time I graduated came, it actually prices went down, even the rents accommodation has become actually the prices actually went low, and it just stayed low for the time being. As you can see in the slide here, this is a brand new accommodation for the students, more than 3,600 beds. It's located in the CBD area, and it's brand new with the bus station that will allow you to go from the city to the nearest bus, from the city to the nearest train station to the university. The university has its own dedicated bus station, and you can go from there. So you don't need actually a car in Perth. Public transport is very affordable. It's quite cheap, and you get around 40% discount as long as you are a student. And for those who don't know that Transperth, which is the transportation company in Western Australia in Perth, it's actually a non-profit company. So they actually, whatever money they get, it's only operational. They don't get any profits from their transportation facilities in Perth. That's why it's very, it's quite cheap. If you go to Melbourne or Sydney, you will actually see the difference in prices when you get a bus ticket or a train ticket. Curtin University today is the most sought after university in Western Australia. 51% of Western Australian people choose to come to Curtin. We have to mention that we have other universities in Curtin, in Perth as well. So we have University of Western Australia, Edith Cowan University, Murdoch University, and Curtin University. Those are the major four universities in Australia. We have also Notre Dame University, which is located near Kalgoorlie, which is around 2 hours flight from Perth. Campuses of Perth, like I've mentioned before, we have a campus in Perth. We have a campus in Kalgoorlie, Singapore, Malaysia, Dubai, and Mauritius. Perth campus is the biggest of them all. So collectively, we have more than 56,000 students. 26% of those 56,000 are international students. More than 4,000 equivalent full-time staff, which is considered the largest employer in Western Australia. And more than 225,000 alumni located around the world. We have four faculties in the Curtin University Perth campus: Faculty of Business and Law, Faculty of Humanities, Faculty of Health Sciences, Faculty of Science and Engineering. So business and law can include accounting, commerce, entrepreneurship. We have more than 23 majors of Bachelor of Commerce, Humanities, which contain education, art, health sciences, which can include pharmacy, nutrition, general health sciences, lab medicine, and so on, and Faculty of Science of Engineering, that contains all the sciences like geology, physics, chemistry, and all the engineering disciplines. We have a dedicated international sponsored student unit to support all international students. That's the department I work for in Curtin University, and we have an engagement team in each faculty. So in each faculty, if you are facing any problems as an international office, you can reach up to the engagement team in your faculty. You can reach to the international sponsored students team, and so on. So for those students who are obtaining direct entry to the university pathway, you can go through either Curtin University straight. So I think you guys are doing CBSE now. That will enable you to kind of give you a direct entry to the university. And for those who don't reach the minimum requirement for direct entry, they can go straight to, to a Curtin College. So we have a college within the university. They can, all the students can go there and do some sort of a foundation year. So 1 year in Curtin College, and the rest of their studies, they move into Curtin University. And for those who are actually also looking to get an English program as well, we do have a Curtin English college inside the Perth campus. So normally for us, like Middle Eastern students, we go to Curtin English. We do certain number of weeks doing English, reach the minimum required for the English. Then we go to Curtin College, do our foundation year. Then we move to Curtin University. COVID-19 situation in Australia and Western Australia. Australian health authorities started to monitor the COVID-19 situation in early January 2020, and it started their alerts at the very beginning. Right now, we can proudly say that there are zero cases of COVID-19 in Western Australia. So what happened was they've locked down the states, so you cannot travel between the states from Western Australia to Northern Territory, New South Wales to Victoria, Queensland, so you cannot move around, and they've actually locked down the country itself. So if you're not an Australian citizen, you're not allowed to go to Australia at the moment. No community transfer of COVID since May 2020. Was not yesterday. So 5th of November 2020 recorded zero new cases and there have been zero new cases until then. Australian borders are currently closed to international travelers. There are some trials that will commence shortly in the Northern Territory and South Australia to bring back some international students from Singapore or China. And as that pilot goes, the government will monitor the program carefully, and then the students can return back to their studies. Our rankings. So we are considered number one in Edu Universal Best MSc in Mineral and Energy Economics. We are considered number two in the world engineering and mining. We are top 100 in civil and structural engineering. We are considered number 35 in the world in earth and marine science. And we are considered in the top 1% in the world global ranking. We are considered number 9 in Australia and number 2 in chemical engineering. And we are also considered number 7 in metallurgical engineering in the world. Getting around in Australia. In Perth. So Curtin, we have Curtin cabs that runs from 7 a.m. to 10:45. It's a free bus. So if you live around the university, there are some free buses that can take you back and forth to where you live. And we also have Curtin driverless bus, where you can get into a bus with no driver that drives around campus. We have public transport, like I've mentioned before, that covers buses, trains, and ferries operated by the company Transperth. It's a 15-minute journey by the bus from the bus station on campus to the Perth Central Business District. And we normally use the smart rider cards. So you have a card, you put some money in it, and you tap in and you tap out as you go around. You can also drive your car. You can buy a car if you'd like to, as long as your license is considered permissible to drive with. And also, but you also need to ensure that you have your insurance policy covered and your registration as well. On campus. So we do have a Curtin Stadium that includes a gym, sport courts, group fitness, beach volleyball, and we have a health center. If you're feeling under the weather, you can visit the health center. Variety of events during the week, plenty of food trucks, and many also stationeries you can buy on campus. Libraries open 24 hours. So you're, if you're that kind of person who likes to study at night, you can just jump in the library at 10 p.m. At 3 a.m. you're finished. You can call one of the security if you live around the university. He can drop you to your house, no fees whatsoever. It's the Also, security is 24 hours, but it's not that you need it, but it's nice to know that the place is very safe. I have lived 6.5 years in Australia, and I am proud to say that I have never been attacked or have never been racially abused or never been profiled in any sort. So either being Arab, being brown, being Muslim, being looking like this. And it was Australian people, they have that kind of, how do you say it, the informalities at the beginning. So if you talk to a lecturer, you call him by his first name. If you want to see him, if you have any problems with your studies, you can just send him an email, set up an appointment, and pop into his office like he is your friend. That's what makes university, Curtin University, quite special. You just talk to him, and he is more than happy to help you. He can guide you. We have clinics that are run in the in each faculty. If you're facing any problems, you can meet with the senior students of your major. They can help you out, and it will be a quite pleasant experience for you in Curtin. Banking in Australia, we do have Bankwest in Australia. Other banks include ANZ, Commonwealth Bank, National Australia Bank, and so on. We have a free Wi-Fi across the whole campus. And we have a shopping center just 5 minutes walk from the campus, where you can find a grocery store that is open until 11 p.m. A lot of types of restaurants, pastas, Domino's, Pizza, Nando's, you name it, Asian food, just next to the university. Curtin is also considered a smoke-free university. So if you want to smoke, you have to actually leave the campus to smoke. We look forward to welcoming you in Curtin University, and this will be the end of my presentation. And I'll stop the share now, and you can pop in your questions in the chat box or open your video. I'll be more than happy to answer your questions. Hello, everyone.
Well, that was quite an impressive presentation. Now let's move on to the queries from our audience. First question. Do you offer any financial support for new students?
We do offer, at the moment, we have a $5,000 scholarship for those who are willing, for those who are enrolling in semester one, 2021. I haven't mentioned before, but most of the courses are available online now, as the COVID situation, and until the borders close, Curtin University is working hard to make most of its courses online or available online.
Small announcement. Dear audience, I request you all to kindly fill up the feedback form given in the chat box or in the comment section for getting your participation certificate. Next question. When did the Curtin University Dubai's programs commence?
Sorry?
When do the Curtin University Dubai's programs commence?
So normally our academic year starts in February, end of February. So the last week of February will be an orientation week, and that will be semester one. Semester two starts in August. And so the last week of August normally is the orientation week for semester two. And each semester is 17 weeks. So 12 weeks of study period, 2 weeks of study breaks during the semester, 1 week study period just before exams, and 2 weeks of exams. That makes it 17 weeks each semester.
Next question. Is the campus closed now? Can I come and see the campus? Dubai campus.
The campus is open. If the borders are open, you can definitely see. The life in Perth and Western Australia is running normal, like there's nothing happening. There's zero cases of COVID, like I've mentioned, and everyone is working normally fine. So we are coming through at the end of semester two in Perth, Western Australia, and we just starting our summer holidays. So for those who doesn't know, because we are in the Southern Hemisphere, it's the other way around. So our winter is in June, July, August, and the summer is December, January, February. And that's an advantage if you live in Oman. You go there during the heat in Oman, and you come back during the nice weather, and you leave Australia during the hot weather.
Next question. Is Curtin University degree recognized in all countries, particularly India?
Yes, Curtin University's degree is recognized all over the world, and also recognized in Oman.
Next question. Can the students study forensic science at your university?
I'm sorry?
Forensic science at your university.
Forensic science. Can I just double check, because we used to have something very similar that was discontinued. Let me double check real quick.
Yes, sure.
We do not offer forensic science at the moment, unfortunately.
Next
but we
question.
Do have biomedical science and chemistry, which is quite similar.
Next question. Are students interviewed as part of the application process?
Not all majors are interviewed. Normally, some of the professional MBAs are interviewed, but 95% of the majors they don't require.
Okay, next question. Whom should I contact if I'm experiencing difficulties with my online application?
StudyCo would be more than happy to help you, and you can also contact me. Elizabeth is, she's the one who actually processed my papers back in 2010, and I have not faced any problems. It was really smooth, and I appreciate her help, and we normally meet and we discuss the students, but as far as I know that the experience of Elizabeth, you will not face any problems.
Okay, thank you. Next question. Are there any courses of dentistry?
We do not offer dentistry at the moment. No, we don't.
Okay, next question. Do you have hostel facilities in your campus?
We do have hostel facilities in our campuses.
What is the rate of job placement of your alumni?
What is the?
Job placement.
Job?
Job placement of your alumni.
It's difficult to give you an exact number, but during these times, I would definitely say it's difficult. But because Perth is considered a regional city, you can always stay back for 3 years. That will give you a 3-year visa where you will be able to work in any job that you find until you find the job that you are kind of the field of study. But during your studies, you can work up to 20 hours a week, and that will easily cover off your living costs. So most of the international students, most of them, even including myself, they worked. And some would say, can you balance between studies and work? It's absolutely normal for students to work and study at the same time. It's not very hectic as a university where they kind of hammer you during the whole semester. No, it's quite chillaxed. I always say, study well, you will pass. Don't study, you will fail. That's the normal philosophy when it comes to university.
Okay, we have a few more questions coming up. Do you have an entrance exam for getting into your college or university?
No, we don't. Most of the majors, especially the undergraduate majors, we don't have an entrance exam.
Okay, next question. Can tuition fees be paid on installments? Like, can we pay monthly?
I will have to get back to you on that point, but normally we receive the fees on the beginning of every semester.
Next question. After studying in Curtin University, Dubai for 2 years, can we continue our study in some other branch of Curtin University?
Yes, you can do it in Dubai for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. You can move around all campuses. As long as your major is available on that campus, you can even do semesters in each campus.
Next question. Do you have campus recruitment at your university?
Campus?
Recruitment.
Do you mean working? Yes, we do have, they work at the university after they finish?
No, do the companies come to the university for recruiting graduates?
Yes. We do have recruitment fairs run every year. Major cities like Chevron, Schlumberger, I mean, that the companies I know of, KPMG, Deloitte, those sort of companies, they come every year and they talk to the students. I must say, even the project that you are doing during your studies, the project, the major, like, the, for example, my design project, my final year project in my major, it was actually a project that was brought from the company Chevron itself. And it's an actual kind of an oil well that needs to be processed and studied.
Next question. Does the course fee differ from one country to another?
Sorry?
Does the course fee differ from one country to another?
Yes. So the course fees differ from one country to another. I would say Malaysia is the cheapest one, Malaysia and Mauritius.
Next question. Are the students allowed to do part-time jobs?
Yes, the students are allowed to work 20 hours a week and unlimited hours during the holidays.
Next question. What are the different modes of study offered by the university, like part-time, full-time badges? Are there any like that?
Yes, as long as you're international office, as long as you're an international student, you will have to be enrolled full-time. So you have to take 100 credits, which is around 4 to 5 units. And you cannot do a part-time job when you're an international office, just international student.
Okay, next question. How and who takes care of children in case of emergencies related to health?
Can you repeat that, please?
How and who takes care of children in case of emergencies related to health?
I missed the first part. How?
How and who takes care of children in case of emergencies related to health?
Children?
Related to health. Like, are there any person who takes care of children if there are any health issues?
Yeah, we do have a health center, a well-being center in the university. So if you're not feeling well, there is a clinic in the university. I myself had a kidney stone while I was studying, and it was quite small. So I went to the clinic, and they told me to drink a lot of water, and thankfully it went out smoothly.
Okay. Next question. When we talk about transportation, is it bus or like metro system?
So we do have buses, trains, and ferries. Okay. And buses around the city, they call the CAT buses. They are free, so you can ride the bus around the city for free. And there are some buses in the university, the yellow buses, that are also free. And we also have ferries, so you can cross the river from one side to another.
Next question. Do you offer any postgraduate courses?
Yes, we do have postgraduate courses in most of our majors, almost all of them.
Next question. Is there any eligibility criteria for getting into the engineering major?
So for the engineering major, you will have to get for the CBSE. Let me see real quick. So you guys doing CBSE, right?
Yes.
Okay, for engineering, you need to get a minimum of 70%. And you have to do mathematics, that includes calculus and physics or chemistry.
Okay. Next question. Is it compulsory to stay on campus?
No. From my experience as a student, I'm talking to you as a student. I would rather if a student stays outside the campus. It's cheaper to live outside the campus.
Okay, that was the final question.
Okay.
Now, I may request Ms. Mubaraka from Study Crew to address the viewers.
I'd like to add here that good evening first to everyone. And thank you, Abdullah, for the wonderful session. I've posted a link in the chat function. Like and follow the StudyCo1 Instagram page and receive an application fee waiver. We will be running competitions in the next few weeks on our Instagram page, so do stay tuned. And if you have any further questions, please contact the StudyCo Oman office and our contact details and the chat function. And we'll be happy to help you with all the application and visa process. So till we meet again, stay safe and take care.
Thank you, sir, for the informative presentation. As we come to the end, as we come to the end of a wonderful session, I would like to express our gratitude to each and everyone behind the grand success of this session. First and foremost, I express a profound gratitude to His Majesty Sultan Haitham bin Tariq for his great vision, leadership, and benevolence. May the Almighty bless His Majesty and this beautiful nation with peace and prosperity. On behalf of Indian School Muscat, the organizing team and the entire audience, extend a very hearty word of thanks to our speakers. We sincerely appreciate the time and efforts you took to share with us the courses you offer. Wholeheartedly, I thank Honorable Chairman, Board of Directors, Indian Schools in the Sultanate of Oman, Dr. Baby Sam Samuel, Honorable members of the board, Mr. Ajay Kumar, Presidents, Indian School Muscat Management Committee, esteemed members of Indian School Muscat Management Committee, our Honorable Principal, Dr. Rajiv Kumar Chauhan, Presidents and esteemed members of all Indian School Muscat Committees in the Sultanate of Oman, Honorable Principals, Vice Principals, Assistant Vice Principals, Supervisors, Coordinators, heads of departments and teachers for their support and guidance for organizing such an event. Thank you all for assisting and encouraging all of us. I thank all the students and parents for being with us today and for your active participation during the entire program. Signing off is Nabhan Najib of Class 11A, Indian School Muscat. Thank you once again, wishing you all success in your future endeavors. Stay safe.
Thank you.